democracy, and that is everyone in here, and especially our wonderful candidates. Yeah, that was fabulous. So you know what I'm going to say right now? I'm going to say that word, money. Yeah. And now Keith is going to tell you how you can give yours to make this campaign a success and bring Jill Stein and Ajamu Baraka into office. Here you go, Keith.
Thank you, Nancy. Hello, everyone. My name is Keith Klingman. I'm a local community organizer and activist. And I just want to say, first of all, what a great honor and pleasure it is to be here for hopefully the next president and vice president of the United States of America, Jill Stein and Ajamu Baraka, activists for the human race, for the earth, for rights, standing up for all of us. And as you know, unlike the Democrats and the Republicans who run on corporate money, lobbyist bribes, we, the Green Party, we do not take corporate money, corporate bribes, and we are not bound or controlled by their influence, by the two-party tyrannical system.
And so what does that mean? That means we are people-powered.
We are people-powered, we are people-funded, we are the campaign. We need everyone to donate, we need you to reach in deep, we need you to give what you can, because campaigns do take money, from going up to the North Dakota access pipelines to going to the next cities where Jill and Ajamu are going to speak, for traveling around, it does take money. On the seats of everyone's chair, QR codes, you can scan them with your phone, it'll bring you to jill2016.com. You can make donations. Also, if you look around, we have people collecting donation slips. They're wearing these.
There's one now! Wave to the folks!
These
Yay!
Nice little glow-in-the-dark neon sticks. And so, whether it's from $5 Fridays, which is tomorrow, by the way, thank God for Friday, $5 Fridays for Jill, or $29 for Stein, or going in something bigger and giving as much as you can. It does take money, but do know that you hear what you get. You have representation in a country where right now we do not have representation. We have taxation without representation, and you see and you hear and you know that with the Green Party, you get people who care and are involved with your life, for making change, for greater good, and so please donate online, ask your friends to help, and get out there with your time, and please help.
Great. Thank you, Keith. Okay, thank you. With the whatever that pattern is. Those of you who know how to use that, donate that way. There are people circulating with baskets. You need to fill out a donation form if you are donating more than $250, and we hope you do. There are also stations, laptops. Some folks have laptops in the lobby. So please give generously. It takes a lot, as you know, to run something like this. We had to pay for this wonderful location, and it was so inexpensive that they didn't include the air conditioning. But we love the People's Church. Let's give a big round of applause for the People's Church. So please do continue. We only have time for three questions, so please do reach deep into your pockets and help make this People Power campaign a success.
So,
yeah, I'm
going to
hit the question.
And as Ajamu said, we have a choice, and we need to help support that voice. So please do what you can for your community, for our Green Party, for our candidates here that are fighting, trying to change our system. Thank you.
All right, thank you, everyone. Here are some questions submitted by you. How do you plan to wage peace in the U.S. and abroad? How do you plan to wage peace in the U.S. and abroad?
Well, you know, Jill sort of touched on a lot of that in her presentation, but let me just say this before I make my comment. I'm really impressed with the turnout this evening, and I come from a tradition where we have to give credit where credit is due, and I want to acknowledge one of the premier organizers here in Chicago, Brother J.R. Fleming, who just came in. Waging peace has to be a top priority, and it will be for this administration. As Jill Stein laid out, we have paid a tremendous price for the adventurism we've seen over the last couple of decades, and especially in the last 16 years. We have in place a commitment on the part of the elite to global domination. It is part of their national strategic strategy that was formulated by neocons toward the latter part of the 1990s and became the guiding document for the George Bush administration and was adopted by the Obama administration. It says basically that they are prepared to use military force to maintain their global hegemony. It says that any regional threat that's perceived by the U.S. government will be dealt with militarily. It says that they will use whatever means necessary to advance that objective. And we are seeing the tragic consequences all around us. So what we say is we have to reverse that. There will be, in fact, a peace offensive. We will use the power of this state for national reconciliation in these various conflict zones. We will prevent the intelligence agencies from engaging in subversive activities in various parts of the world. We will withdraw from the African continent the African strategic military operation AFRICOM. We will abide by international law, we will strengthen international institutions, and we will attempt to impose that, but to suggest a new kind of international morality.
What, in your opinion, is the significance of getting money out of politics? Thanks, Jill.
Oh, thank you. Okay. Yeah.
We need to get the money out of politics so we can get the people back in. That's what the significance is. And we're the ones who need to do that. Many years ago, when I was just first tricked into running for office. In my home state, in Massachusetts, we were passing a voter referendum to get the money out of politics. It's not rocket science. We can create public financing of political campaigns and stop this deal making between corporate donors and lobbyists and rich donors and politicians who make implicit deals. When you're taking the big money, there's an expectation of a return favor. So we got together in my home state in Massachusetts, and all of us who were being beaten back by the power of money, that is, the labor unions and the public health advocates and the advocates for Medicare for all, for a single-payer system, and for an end to environmental racism and the effort to shut down our polluting incinerators and coal plants. We were all being beaten back on these really critical issues by the power of money. We got together, and on a voter referendum, we passed campaign finance reform. Then the Democrats in the legislature, 85% of the legislature, they repealed public financing for political campaigns. And it told me that the revolution will not happen. This was back in 2002. It was pretty clear the revolution is not going to happen inside of a political party that is funded by the big money and the war profiteers and the predatory banks and the fossil fuel giants. We can get money out of politics. In addition to public financing, we can liberate the public airwaves. They belong to us. Campaigns don't have to cost us billions of dollars. If we have free media for ballot qualified candidates, then running for office is cheap and we can afford to finance it publicly. This is not rocket science. This is about our standing up with the courage of our convictions and saying we are not going to take it anymore. We deserve real democracy and we can have it now so that we can create the world that we deserve. Thank you.
All right, this is from Henry, age 13. What will Jill do to reform public education?
Great question, Henry. Yes, this too is not rocket science. We need to start fully funding all of our public schools like they all matter, because they do. Quality public schools. Put a different way. Quality education should not be a choice, because if it's a choice, some people get it and some people don't. It should be a right, not a choice. That means it's time to end high-stakes testing and teach to the whole student for lifetime learning. We need to bring back art and music and recreation and community education. It's not rocket science about how to teach kids. It means ensuring that kids come to school ready to learn. The biggest obstacle to learning is called poverty. It's time to end poverty. So kids come to school ready to learn, and it's time to support our teachers and their unions, because they are the heart and soul of our education system. We need to value them, ensure that they have small class sizes, ensure that they have the budget they need to actually do their job and teach these students. And we say, go Chicago.
Green Card.